added. The question that we are asking tonight is, isn't it time, to make our MPs pay for no work? Isn't it time to make our MPs pay for no work? Let's just open up the debate here on the News Hour tonight. It is Saber Swiping with Pawan Verma of the JDU, with Mr. Arvind Sawant and Mr. Gaurav Bhatia, two members of parliament who have parliamentary experience and one who hopes to get there someday, if I may say so. But let me ask Mr. Pawan Verma, senior leader of the JDU, ex-MP now, but he's been there in parliament. Arvind Sawant is there in Lok Sabha for the Shiv Sena, championing their cause. But gentlemen, what is happening? Why is the Aam Aadmi having to look at such a bad investment? Already we are upset with bad loans, Mr. Pawan Verma, but now this is turning out to be a really bad investment.
Anand, I can't agree with you more that the daily spectacle that we see in Parliament is an outrage. It is alienating the youth from the process. It is no advertisement for India being the world's largest democracy. Parliament is the highest forum where there should be civilized discussion and debate, and the manner in which it is proceeding from this session and many sessions before that needs to be roundly condemned, and the time has come to say enough is enough, because the people of India, I think, have had enough. Let me say to you that in its entire history, the House of Commons has not been adjourned for a single day, and soon we are going to set the record that there is not a single day when our parliament is not adjourned. I think the contrast speaks for itself.
Who is to blame?
Having said this, I will take 30 seconds to say, now that's the question. I think all parties are to blame for it. In the last session before this government came to power, the BJP made it an art to disturb parliament and in fact provided ideological reasoning for it. Both Mr. Arun Jaitley and Sushma Swaraj, both of whom I greatly respect, actually justified it as a part of acceptable parliamentary practice to disturb parliamentary proceedings. Once that was set in train, now when you are in power and the other party is in opposition, it follows the example that you have set, and this vicious cycle goes on unstopped. So all parties need to introspect. But I will add to this. The primary responsibility of running the house is with the treasury benches, and they need to ask themselves that if their own party's allies are at the forefront of disrupting the house, have they done enough to talk with them in order to prevent that kind of disruption? And the last point I want to make is, the Speaker of the House and the presiding officer of the Raj Sabha, the Honorable Chairman of the House, they have unimaginably vast powers to discipline unruly members. It's laid down and it is beyond the interrogation of any other authority. They are supposed to exercise those powers. I asked this question on your channel today, that the Speaker can name a member, can suspend a member, can ask a member to leave, can suspend his daily allowance for any violation of the decorum and dignity and etiquette of the House, leave alone coming into the well and holding placards. Why do the presiding officers not set an example?
Sir, fair point.
That disciplinary action.
Let the BJP answer before I bring in the Shiv Sena. Let the BJP answer. Now I'm just going to read out 10 key bills, ladies and gentlemen, before I bring in Gaurav Bhatia. The Citizenship Amendment Bill of 2016, the Financial Resolution and Deposit Insurance Bill of 2017, the Rights of Children to Free and Compulsory Education, Second Amendment Bill 2017, the Women's Reservation Bill, the Lokpal and Lokayuktas Law Amendment Bill 2014, then You have the Citizenship Amendment Bill I talked about. Then you have the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill 2016. Then you have the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2016. Don't these all need to be debated? Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill, the Triple Talaq Bill, still stuck. Financial Resolution and Deposit Insurance Bill, National Medical Commission Bill 2017. All these bills are pending, along with the Interstate Water Disputes Amendment Bill 2017. So this list is long. What is happening, Gaurav Bhatia? the onus on getting the parliament together and get it to function is the government. Does the government want parliament to function?
No, first of all, I would say that if Mr. Pawan Verma, who is a very seasoned leader, says the onus is only on the opposition or on the treasury benches to make sure that the parliament session is constructive, then I would tell you that during the BJP government's regime, most of these sessions have been very productive. In fact, some of the sessions have been, you know, more productive than even 100%. They finished the work on the agenda and much more. And compare this to, you know, when the Congress government was there, there were sessions where there was 10%, 11% of productivity for the entire session. Mm. But I would say that, you know, we would be living in a fool's paradise to say that the onus only lies with the treasury benches and not with every individual member of parliament. And why do I say that? I think it is a primary function and a constitutional duty that has been cast upon a member of parliament to ensure that he participates constructively. Now the approach of the opposition has been completely confrontationalist. And I will give you an example. Earlier, the opposition benches had demanded that Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji should come on the floor of the house and address the concerns of the opposition parties. When he came in the last session, we all saw when he was making his speech for 1 hour in the Lok Sabha and also for around that time in the Rajya Sabha, there was slogan shouting and people were disrupting him. Sir, now this is not what you expect from member of parliament.
My submission, sir, is I would like to see that this government, if it says Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas, it should first be able to get Sabka Saath. If you are not able to get Sabka Saath in the parliament, then how are you going to practice it on
so
the
let me tell you, Anand, another number which is very important.
One minute, Arvind Sawant wants to rebut. Yes, Arvind Sawant.
I think Honorable Pawan Verma, who is a senior leader, I mean, whatever he has said is absolutely correct. I myself don't feel that the house should be adjourned for this ruckus which is being played in the parliament. But then you can't help it. As he has, at the final sentence, when somebody has said Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, where is that Sabka Saath? And the Sabka Saath is not existing, that is what the problem. And therefore, second question is that, it is responsible to everybody. It's not only a treasury bench or an opposition bench. But treasury bench responsibility is much more than the others because they have to get the bills passed. And they have to show that we have done it in during their tenure. But it is not happening so. There is no communication. And dictatorship type actions are going on. That is what is creating problem.
No, but
and tit for tat is action also ruling.
Correct.
Suppose somebody from Congress party starts speaking on such issues and then the other people go on shouting. The chair did not stop them, and when the Prime Minister wants to go speak on the other shouting brigade goes and sits on the chair, and then the opposition says, "Hey, why this discrimination?" And therefore they started shouting. This is what is happening. Very sorry about it. Why they have to come into the well?
No.
One minute. Let me come to a very important statement.
Sure.
Are we really functioning on a democratic way? Look at up in Delhi. They won 63 seats. Hmm. Whether their all actions are correct or wrong, that is a different part of it.
Hmm.
Do we allow them to function? This is what the democracy. And therefore, Vandaniya Balasaheb is to say, are we really working in a democratic manner?
Sir,
that is what really
I'll tell you what.
Unless you really
respond to him,
this is honor the opposition.
I am looking at it as an Aam Aadmi. Gaurav Bhatia wants to respond. My simple point is, as an Aam Aadmi, jab ek baar aap parliament mein chale gaye, to aap sab hamare representative hain. पार्लियामेंट हमारे खर्चे पे चलता है, मैंने से हमारे खर्चे पे जो टैक्स भर रहा है, दैट इज आल्सो 4.5% ऑफ दिस कंट्री दैट इज पेइंग टैक्स ऑफ द इनकम अर्नर्स. ओनली 4.5% पीपल आर पेइंग टैक्स और 5% पीपल आर पेइंग टैक्स. उस पर से सो मच ऑफ मनी इज बीइंग स्पेंट इन एवरी सेशन इन रनिंग द पार्लियामेंट. माई पॉइंट इज सर, अगर आप लोग काम नहीं कर रहे हो तो कहीं तो पनिशमेंट होना चाहिए ना. That's the simple sentiment that comes across from the viewer, from the Aam Aadmi. Because if I don't come to work, or if I do halla bol at work, if I do dharna, I lose my pay.
You know, Anand, I would like to respond to what Arvindji was saying. See, we have to understand parliament is the temple of democracy and 1.25 billion people look up to the members of parliament as well as to the proceedings of the Parliament House. If you have any merit in the objections or the issues you are raising, expose the government through the strength of your argument. And the opposition parties have been guilty of committing three cardinal sins. Just take the complete point, Anand. First, this is slogan shouting is not acceptable. Second, raising placards,
provided
as the chairperson of the Rajya Sabha, Mr. Venkaiah Naidu, also said, he was pained to see placards being, you know, used inside the Parliament.
And third,
also rushing to the well. I say, when GST, which required GST required a constitutional amendment, and
sure
we could sort out our differences,
do you have short-term memory loss? Because 2012 is very fresh in the minds of a lot of people, but when people have come out and quoted what Mr. Arun
how the opposition
at that time and the government of the day
kind of
You see the segments of the party
happening. The Supreme Court had cancelled the allotment, and when we were asking the then Prime Minister and the respective Minister to speak, he wasn't coming forward to speak on the subject.
The entire nation was asking for those.
Senior ministers like Arun Jaitley ji are available.
Just 1 minute.
Coming to the party to answer the question.
Pawan Verma ji, this
Gaurav is a friend and I respect what he's saying, but I want to say, the moment you introduce this element, that some issues are such, especially those that are being espoused by you, which justify disrupting Parliament, and other issues which may be raised by parties opposed to you are not of a nature which justify disrupting Parliament. You are already laying down the ideological ground that when it suits you, you disrupt Parliament, and when it doesn't suit you, you blame those who disrupt Parliament.
I'd like to respond to
that. My view is that all political parties need to introspect, and there is a factor. There is a factor that one should not suffer, and
now,
I don't mean that in a partisan way. It can apply to any political party. It can apply to any political party that no party should suffer from the syndrome called absolute majority. In other words, we will have our way in the Lok Sabha, and if we are not having our way in the Raj Sabha, all of those who are opposing us are people whom we treat across enemy lines. In other words, we relinquish our duty as the ruling party to reach out to those opposing us behind the scenes, in the chambers, in the business advisory committees, and reach out and try to reach a modus vivendi, a meeting ground, which breaks the impasse. That onus and responsibility is far more on the Minister of Parliamentary Affairs of the ruling party. In fact, Pranab Mukherjee used to say to his Minister of Parliamentary Affairs in
I want to see you more in the opposition side. Sir, my simple point is, don't make a justification for the disruption, like the allegation is that the Treasury bench needs to reach out to the opposition. The allegation is also on the opposition that they deliberately want to disrupt because
it's an obstructionist approach.
They just want to show you obstructed for 2 years, so we'll obstruct you.
It's not true, Gauruji. Opposition,
you deceive the people. There is bound to be a reaction.
Pawan Verma ji started this debate by first saying that
he had introduced this trend of obstructing the parliament.
Also, if you would have gone back in time, when we were in the treasury benches, even at that time, the opposition parties used to obstruct. But I would say and second his thoughts that he is right, that there can't be any exception. Parliament is meant to function, to legislate, and therefore this big responsibility on every member of Parliament that they constructively put forward their points. But it is very painful when we have seen a new trend that opposition parties are also casting aspersions on the chair of the house, be it the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha.
सर, गवर्नमेंट और ऑपोजिशन, ट्रेजरी बेंचेस और अदरवाइज, अरविंद सावंत, द सिंपल पॉइंट इज सर, अगर आपको आपका सैलरी हाइक फ्रॉम 50,000 रुपीज टू 1 लाख रुपीज चाहिए, देन उसका काम करके दिखाओ. दैट इज समथिंग विच यू विल टेल एनीबडी हु यू आर पेइंग सैलरीज टू. सर,
अरे भैया, सैलरी क्या, एक एक आपकी बात सही है, सैलरी क्या सिर्फ पार्लियामेंट में काम आते हैं इसके लिए मिलती है क्या? सैलरी सिर्फ पार्लियामेंट में आती है इसके लिए मिलती है? अच्छा एक बात मुझे बताओ, आप मैंने देखा है कि चैनलों पे पार्लियामेंट की उनकी सैलरी की बात बहुत बार की जाती है, कभी मीडिया की भी पे सैलरी पता नहीं
चलती सर। हम तो
भाई आपको क्या मिल
रहा है? बहुत लगता है तो बुरा लगता है। तो सही सुनिए, तो सही
सुनिए,
मुझे पूरी बात कर रहा है, मुझे यही बात पार्लियामेंट You are representing the voice of the people on the floor of the house, or are you doing a tamasha and
You are not allowing me to complete. That is not fair. This is again a democratic way. This is not the way you should function. We are much more accountable, and every now and then we have to face election. Second, let me complete. Go to the states, go to every state and see how much salary is given to the MLA. And then compare with the member of parliament. Just don't single out the member of parliament. Go to the states and see how much salary is given to the MLAs of this state.
Sir, I have no problems.
You deserve a short vacation.
देखिए 2.5 लाख रुपया पर मिनट हमारा खर्चा होता है पार्लियामेंट की अपकीप में, इतना आपकी डिमांड होती है। प्रिविलेजेस के लिए पूरा हाउस फुल रहता है, प्रिविलेजेस और सैलरी अप्रूवल के लिए हाउस फुल रहता है। ये जो दस बिल है नीरव मोदी जैसे इशू पर आपको डिबेट करना है, फार्मर क्राइसिस पे डिबेट डिस्कशन करना है, हाउस एबसेंट रहता है। दैट इज अ सिंपल बाइनरी। हम लोग बहुत सिंपल लोग हैं, सिंपल तरीके से समझा रहे हैं। वी डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम विद यू गवर्नमेंट पार्लियामेंट इज मेकिंग, काम कीजिए, कमाइए सर, काम कीजिए। पवन वर्मा लास्ट वर्ड।
फार्मर्स के ऊपर डिस्कशन नहीं हुई क्या? आप कैसे भूल जाते
सर? पार्लियामेंट का फंक्शन नहीं हुआ, 8 दिन की छुट्टी, 2 दिन का काम, लेकिन 10 दिन की सैलरी, ये क्या लॉजिक हुआ बताइए? ये क्या लॉजिक हुआ बताइए? 8 दिन की छुट्टी, 2 दिन का काम, 10 दिन की सैलरी। सर मैं भी ऐसा जॉब करना चाहूंगा, मुझे तो नहीं अलाउ करेंगे लोगों की मैं सिर्फ सैटरडे को आके न्यूज आर करूं और लेकिन मंडे टू संडे का की सैलरी ले जाऊं, ऐसा नहीं अलाउ करेंगे ना? पवन वर्मा लास्ट वर्ड
किया, आनंद आनंद ले लो ना, उसमें कोई दिक्कत